We welcome you to Assembly Hall here in Bloomington, Indiana. Number 2, Ohio State, taking on number 15, Indiana. Dan Dockage, Dave O'Brien with it. And Dan, take us for a one-on-one.
Well, this is a matchup of two terrific post kids for Ohio State. It's Jared Sullinger. And Ohio State does a terrific job of getting the ball and showcasing Sullinger. You see 25 double-doubles. If he can get his feet into the paint, he's unstoppable. For Indiana, they have not done such a great job with Cody Zeller. Only 5 shots against Michigan State. In this game, they have to help Zeller, either screening, pick and pop, get him the ball, more than the 5 shots he got against Michigan State.
For Ohio State, Sullinger, Aaron Kraft, and William Buford, they could all wind up with Big Ten or All-America honors. But Deshaun Thomas scores 16 a game. He hit for 22 against the Hoosiers last year. For Indiana, Hulls and Christian Watford both hit over 50% on threes. Oladipo has terrific leaping ability. And Verdell Jones III is a 1,000-point scorer. Indiana and the home whites, an excellent shooting team. And Indiana wins the opening tip. This much-anticipated game, we are underway on the same court where Indiana has already knocked off the number 1 team in the country, Kentucky, now trying to do it to the number 2 team in the country.
Yeah, and Indiana was not afraid on this court to run with Kentucky, and look for Indiana here to run with Ohio State.
Zeller's first touch in the lane, and won't find a range there. Rebound hauled in by Lenzel Smith Jr. Ohio State coming in at 13-1. Their only loss at Kansas, with Sullinger out of that game with back spasms. Up top, Buford is making a run at being the all-time leading scorer at Ohio State. In quickly, and one, Sullinger. A motion right away, and he'll go to the line for a 3-point play.
Well, remember this all game. You have to be in help early. Sullinger's going to roll after a screen, but Verdell Jones is just waiting to accept Sullinger, and that's a mismatch. In this game, the help side defender on the screen roll has to get in front of, between the ball and the rolling man. If you're late, it's going to be a 3-point play.
Verdell Jones with the foul. Quick start for Ohio State. Indiana 12-1. They're coming off a loss this week, 80-65 at the hands of Michigan State in East Lansing. Here's Watford, the star of the Kentucky game, left it way short, and Sullinger with the rebound. And he winds up traveling with it. Tom Crane, the head coach for the Hoosiers. He has them in the top 25 for the first time since he came to Bloomington to return Indiana to college hoops royalty. And up against Thad Matta, since taking over at Ohio State in 04, he has the best record in the Big Ten, best winning percentage at 78%.
Yeah, and how about 6 titles in his 12 years as a head coach, as a Division I head coach?
Kraft trying to make a move quickly, and he is so fast.
Well, that's just a matter of Aaron Kraft playing harder than Verdell Jones. Kraft just put his head down and went. Jones had an angle on him, but relaxed. Kraft took advantage of it.
Zeller on the low block up against Sullinger, trying to get around him in the lane. A lot of contact, no foul, and Sullinger with another rebound. Buford high up on the wing. Here's Sullinger, short jumper. Rebound loose in the corner. Here's Thomas. Another scramble for the rebound. Lenzel Smith came away with it. Another miss. Gets it back. That one gets into the basket. And a fast start, 7-0 for Ohio State.
Well, if you remember David Leidy from Ohio State for the last 5 years playing, that's what Lenzel Smith does. He's a kid that provides activity, energy on the defensive end, offensive boards. Whatever needs to be done, he does.
Jordan Hulls, a 6-foot junior, running the point. Here's Oladipo. He's averaging about 12 a game.
Dave, this is something to watch. Indiana 2 times has gone into Zeller, but they've done it without getting him any type of advantage, either through a screen or some type of movement, and Sullinger's been able to play him both times.
Watford, a lot of iron, but it drops in for the first 2 for the Hoosiers tonight.
That's a great matchup for Indiana. Second time they went to Watford. Second time Deshaun Thomas allowed Watford to just step in. Sullinger is playing much better defense on Zeller than Thomas is on Watford.
Here's the kick to Lenzel Smith, and well short. And a foul and a rebounding fray. 17:20 to go here in the first half from Assembly Hall, which can be flat out the loudest arena in college basketball when these fans really get it going. Thomas with the foul. We'll see how loud they get tonight. It was absolute bedlam here in the game against Kentucky.
People saw the shot that went in. But it was that way before the game, during the game, at timeouts, constantly throughout the course of that game.
Oladipo, too strong. Rebound comes out high. Kraft wants to run. Kraft, one of the top point guards in the country, trying to take on Hulls, who knocks that one away. Great stop there by Hulls on the baseline. He comes away. Here's a long one. Well, he hits 52% out there from three-point land.
That's a welcome sight for Hoosier fans. Jordan Hulls, 2 for 10, 0 for 4 against Michigan State, and he was the topic of conversation all week long among basketball fans in the state of Indiana.
Sullinger out of the double. Nice play there. Smith, the open man for two.
See, again, the help side guy. In this case, it was Watford. He was late. He didn't know where to go. If you do that against Ohio State, they take advantage of it.
Taylor thought about it a little closer. Slap on a foul by Sullinger. Reaching in, he picks up his first. So number one on Thad Matta's star and the National Player of the Year candidate.
Well, Jared Sullinger really bailed out Cody Zeller. The last jump shot Cody Zeller had taken in a game was against Butler, and he airballed it from right there. Right now, you're in pretty good shape. Rule of thumb in coaching, whether it's sixth grade through NBA, is never foul the jump shooter.
He's made 65% of his shots overall, 76% at the line, but hits the first one off the very front of the iron.
Dave, you see that bandage he has on his arm? He got banged up in practice and got bruised, started wearing it. Well, Indiana started winning, so he's kept it on. But he tells people that he has a tattoo that he doesn't want anybody to see. He's a great kid. He's a fun, fun kid, as are his two brothers.
Kraft again, the quick step for two, and that's something they're going to have to make an adjustment on.
Yeah, they are. You drive the ball towards Buford. That's what Kraft did there. Oladipo could not leave Buford, and Sullinger did a great job of walling off the help, which in that case was Cody Zeller.
You and I saw Kraft absolutely terrorize the Florida Gators defensively for 40 minutes. Forget about the offense that he could occasionally bring, and they forced the second turnover of the game.
Well, that's what he does, Aaron Kraft. He beats you down to where, you know, you've either got to toughen up or guys quit.
A little step back by Buford, pretty sweet there. Two-pointer by William Buford, the 6'6 senior. He's coming off a big game against Northwestern this week. He scored 26. Oladipo went up high for the rebound. Here's Verdell Jones off the mark. Zeller there for the rebound. Right back up.
Much more active this game and much more comfortable is Cody Zeller now. He should be, because Michigan State had two guys, Adrian Payne at 6'10", long arm, to bang on him, and Derek Nix, and a very much improved Derek Nix. This should be an easier game for Cody Zeller.
Thomas into the lane. Fires it up with the left hand, no. Rebound tipped out. Here's Thomas again. That one won't fall, and the foul. That's going to be an offensive foul. With 14:56 to go here in the first half, pace heating up. Ohio State leading it 13-7.
Heads up, Dave.
Luxury cars that deliver inspired performance.
Back at Assembly Hall here in Indiana, Dan Dockich and Dave O'Brien alongside. And on the last evening of 2011, the Hoosiers will try to do something they haven't done in six tries. That's beat the Buckeyes. It's the longest winning streak in this rivalry. However, Indiana has won the last four times in which both schools were ranked. That goes back to January of 06. And look at the last time Indiana won. Look who the head coach was. It was Dan Dockich. What do you remember about that one?
I'm sure Eric Gordon had something to do with it. I pulled that to the floor. I do remember we were up at half and had missed a ton of open shots. And it was a back-and-forth game second half. Costas Koufos was killing us in his own, but DJ White took care of it. That's what I remember. I'm feeling really good after
and
the
feeling
game.
Feeling pretty darn good, I'll
really
bet.
Really good.
Here 13-7, Ohio State on top, and Indiana with the ball. On this floor, December 10, they beat number one Kentucky on that buzzer beater by Christian Watford. Tom Crean said, you know, it was not hard to get everyone's feet back on the ground after they said right back to practice the next day. I thought everyone was level-headed and ready to go.
You know, he made a great point. He said Miguel Jones and Christian Watford really took care of that, and that was something that would not have happened a year ago.
Oladipo around and out had a pretty good look from the corner.
He had a great look because Jared Sullinger had fallen down, and Buford went to help on Zeller quickly, and it's as good a look as he'll get.
Kick ball there. Ravenel into the ball game for Ohio State. The transfer from Boston College on the floor.
Ravenel's in the game because of Deshaun Thomas's lack of defense. And because I think Thomas is going a little quick. He's from Fort Wayne, Indiana. Was Mr. Basketball here in the state. Wants to settle him down a minute.
Boy, Buford doesn't need much of an opening. And he doesn't need anyone to tell him twice to shoot the ball.
No, it never has. Ever since he was at Toledo Libby High School. Playing for a great coach in Leroy Bates. He was always a kid that was going to let her fly.
We'll start so far shooting it for Indiana, Dan. Just 30%. This is a team that ranks among the best shooting teams in the country. Foul here against Ohio State with 13:55 to go in the opening half, and that'll go against Smith. Indeed, Tom Crean's team shooting 50% overall from the field, 45% from three, which makes them number one in the country.
Well, one of the reasons for that is Cody Zeller likes to play inside out. He'll pass the ball out along Indiana's perimeter to step into shots. And the other thing is, you know, Indiana's been very unselfish making extra passes. And the third thing is, other than Kentucky at North Carolina State, they played a really easy schedule.
Yes. Now tonight, facing the number two ranked team in America.
I have to correct that. I think Butler's going to be really good. They did play Butler. Butler won today coming from behind. Beating Butler, I don't care whether it was here or how they were playing, that's a good win no matter what.
Knocked away by Watford. Buford goes sprawling for it, wants a timeout, and he got it. So some smart basketball there by Buford. So as not to turn it over. 15-7 Ohio State. Well, Thad Mata has been successful in the paint here tonight. Ohio State with 7 field goals, Dan, and 5 have come in the lane.
Couple off offensive rebounds. They've taken the ball to the rim, haven't settled for a jump shot. We've seen Aaron Kraft go to the rim and go strong to the rim. So getting points in the paint is not just throwing it on the block. There's a variety of ways to get that done. Like right here, he's going to the paint.
Kraft fouled by Hulls, trying to get in front of him. That'll be his first personal on Jordan Hulls, the junior from Bloomington, right here. Hometown kid, very popular with the fans. Now the students obviously aren't here because of the break. That could make a profound difference in this game, can't it?
There's no question. There's a different energy in here. What it is a number of people getting tickets that live in Indianapolis or surrounding areas because those tickets are available without the students. And as everybody that follows college sports knows, students create the energy in the arena 9 out of 10 times.
Sullinger on the back down to the paint, draws the foul. It's going to roll off the iron, but he'll go to the line to shoot two. Sullinger has always been a very reliable foul shooter. Up against Zeller. That time Pritchard committed the foul, however. And Sullinger will shoot two. Sullinger missed 2 games with the back spasms. Also had a banged up foot. But the All-American and Player of the Year candidate scored 21 against Duke. And Coach K said later, he is the best player in America.
A lot of good players. And he's got one on his own team in William Buford, who I think is an All-American. But Jared Sullinger is now just getting back into the form that we saw early when they played Florida. He played great, was hurt, and now he's making a comeback to where he was.
A 10-point lead for the Buckeyes. That's really quieting the crowd more than any other thing, probably. Hall's trying to get around. Buford will foul him. Had his hands on him to pick up his first. Well, 1974 and 75, the Hoosiers also started their seasons 12-0, as they did this year, before finally losing against Michigan State this week.
Yeah, I don't know what happened in 42, but I know 75 was an undefeated regular season.
Yeah.
76 was an undefeated national champion.
That's some pretty good teams there under Bob Knight.
Yeah.
Hulls in the corner. Ravenel came out to guard him. Now he's bottled up. Tried to fire it off him. Now a collision and a foul. That'll go against Aaron Kraft, number one.
This is where Indiana has had problems, Dave. Jordan Hulls was trapped in the corner, but he has Tom Pritchard wide open. Indiana's guards have done a very poor job all year at looking towards the basket, whether it's to post speed or get out of traps. They always look left or they look right. They rarely, if ever, look straight down, and it's cost them. And it certainly cost them in the Kentucky game late. They were bailed out, but it also cost them in the Michigan State game.
Rudell Jones getting his own shot, not there. Zeller with the rebound, knocked away by Ravenel. Kraft looking up the court. Outstanding passer as well as a great defender, and a traveling violation on Buford. Say something else, one more foul by Ohio State and Indiana. In fact, they are shooting bonuses, so 17-7, Ohio State with a 10-point lead. Indiana could be on the line a lot here in the first half. Jones on the move. Oladipo worked a lot in his outside shot, but he can do that too. Knifing in, not there. Tipped up and in by Zeller. Got the right hand up there.
What a terrific drive, Oladipo to the rim. Ravenel came up to help, which is a cardinal rule of interior defense. When Ravenel came up, it opened up the baseline backboard for Cody Zeller.
Buford off the screen. Sullinger on Pritchard. Out of the double team. Jump shot from the corner, and that's off target. Rebound comes out to Zeller. Here's Oladipo. Indiana gets a terrific shooter in the game in Matt Roth, who is a sensational three-point man. Oladipo, tough angle there. Poked out. Here comes Ohio State. Seibert high up on the wing, the sophomore from Cincinnati. That was intended for Sullinger. Eventually, Ravenel draws the foul, hard foul, too, and he'll go to the line to shoot a pair with 10:59 to go. Timeout, 17-9, Ohio State in the early going at Assembly Hall.
They've got 5.6 seconds, and it's prayer time. Two-point lead, no timeouts for Indiana. Jones, Watford for the win! As Indiana knocks off number one Kentucky.
Well, that was 3 weeks ago today. Christian Watford's last second shot to stun number one Kentucky on this very court.
Well, talk to John Calipari about that. And with a young team, sometimes they don't execute. Cody Zeller came up and set a great screen on Marcus Teague. And I think it was Darius Miller was supposed to come up with him and just foul. They had two fouls to give. Nobody came up with Zeller. And it freed the ball handler, and next thing you know, in a scramble situation, Watford set up in his favorite spot, which is the left wing.
And the foul never came.
Though, and people you saw the end of it, which was everybody on the court. But as you watched that game, that energy was there the entire ball game, and that's something that's great in the non-conference season, to see teams play on each other's home court as opposed to a neutral site.
Ravenel still with two seasons to go after transferring from BC, and makes the pair. Now Ohio State has not trailed in this one, their biggest lead. Back up to 10 points. Get Derek Elston into the ballgame. He's wearing that mask after breaking his nose in practice a couple of weeks ago. Tough shot by Walker, but everything in the lane is contested. Now on the run, Sullinger. Great dish there to Seibert. But it's going to be a foul to go the other way. Offensive foul against Ohio State.
Well, Matt Roth did what you're supposed to do in transition. He sprinted back, put his head under the basket. You're going to see Roth comes back, puts his head right there under the basket. Now, there will be debate on two things, though, whether or not Roth was set, and you have to allow Sullinger to come down. And if you watch Roth's feet, is he inside that three-foot arc that is new to college basketball?
I thought that was a restricted arc play right there.
I did too.
It's an attempt to limit the number of collisions near the basket on block charge plays, and it seemed tailor-made. But an offensive foul on Sullinger. Tipped away by Seibert. Roth goes to get it.
And now you're sitting here, if you're Ohio State, and you have Sullinger and Thomas both with two fouls, and you've got to kind of hold the fort here for a while.
Hulse. Yes, all nets. 52% from three, one of four Hoosiers shooting 45% or better from beyond the three-point line this year.
Well, he just sized up the freshman, Scott. It's a lot easier for Halls against Scott than it was Applin the other night. This is where it'll get tough. Buford has to get the ball here.
Shannon Scott threw it away. The freshman gave it up. That's five turnovers for the Buckeyes. Elston gives it back out for Hulls. Kraft is about to return for Ohio State after he gets a breather. Hulls nearly went down there. Elston, a shot clock at 13, airborne. Went for his own rebound and could not handle it.
But Derek Elston is shooting a floater. It's not what Indiana needed. Derek Elston, had he caught the ball, gotten low, would have been able to go to the rim, put two hands on the backboard. Really, there's only one guy should be shooting the ball for Ohio State here, and that's Buford.
Sidered well short. Feel the tide turning now in the Hoosiers' favor all of a sudden. Hulls got airborne, got it off to Pritchard. He had to make the adjustment. Elston will shoot it. Got a good look, not there. Ravenel swinging that elbow to get everybody away from him. Ravenel, he has some skills down there, but that one airmailed. Williams tied up and fouled by Pritchard, the youngster Amir Williams.
Shot 3 of 28 from the three-point line. Gave up 72 points.
Buford fouled as he went up to take the shot with 8:25 to go. Let's see what they do with this call. 19-12. Take another look on the inbounds.
How can that not be a two-shot shooting foul?
A timeout. 19-12, Ohio State by 7. 8:25 in the first half here from Assembly Halls. We can say happy holiday to you. 19-12, Ohio State has the 7-point lead. Everybody in the spirit here. As we get ready to turn the page on 2011, Dan Dockich, Dave O'Brien with you. Ohio State has gone almost 6 minutes without a field goal, Dan.
Well, they brought Aaron Kraft in, so now the only two guys that should score or should shoot here is Buford or Kraft driving it.
Hulls went right into a screen set by Williams and went down. Buford dribbled it off the foot, but it's off Indiana's foot. That was off Christian Watford.
This is a terrific move by Tom Crean, putting Christian Watford. You see Watford hands up, active. It went off his foot, but a great move by Tom Crean, putting Christian Watford on Buford.
Rebound tipped out high, Oladipo. He can be a highlight film when he really gets into that open floor. He's a tremendous dunker. Watford gives it out, Oladipo there. And this one tightens up considerably, a four-point game.
Smart play by Watford. Had the shot, didn't take it, drove it in the lane, could have shot off balance. Instead of doing that, found an open Oladipo.
6-0 run here for Indiana. Ohio State has missed their last 5 shots. Kraft, that's a foul on Watford. He's just trying to get in front of Kraft. It is not an easy thing to stay in front of Aaron Kraft. Oladipo, money from the wing, a triple. Well, back in Indiana, and some of the great supporters of Indiana basketball in the house here tonight. And that includes John Mellencamp, along with Meg Ryan. There they are, taking in the game. And unfortunately, a key young player for the Indiana Hoosiers not able to go tonight because of an ankle injury. Sheehy has been out. Will Sheehy averaging 11 points per game. And what do you think they'll get him back? You spoke to him earlier tonight.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I think it may be a week or two. He was so down about not playing in this game. He didn't play in the Michigan State game. Rolled an ankle. And Boy, is he a tough, tough kid. He and Oladipo have changed the approach of Indiana basketball. Their toughness has rubbed off on everybody.
Buford bounces in for Williams. Made a fine adjustment there in the lane.
And that's what I mean. William Buford has to shoot. He didn't shoot there, but he handled it until somebody came to stop him from others. That time it was Williams' man. It's like Robbie Hummel with Purdue. Robbie Hummel with Purdue has to play like he's going to lead the country in scoring. Exhaust all options before you give up the ball.
So he gave up the dribble. Ohio State had gone 7 minutes in between field goals. Now they force a turnover.
Dave, that's another post feed that Indiana did not make. It's been a problem all year for them against good teams.
Williams very active. He draws the foul. We're still trying to figure out why Buford, a couple of possessions ago, deep in the left corner, wasn't going to the line on a two-shot foul. They ruled he was fouled on the floor. I find it hard to believe. A foul here on Zeller. So Williams to the line. Here Williams, 6'11 freshman from Birmingham, Michigan. A little trouble at the line. He's 5 out of 13 for the year. Ohio State, and a lot of this has to do with Williams being in the game, the McDonald's All-American. They are plus 10 on the boards here early.
Well, Williams has done a good job on both ends of the floor, but
Rudell Jones slicing in for two, just kept on trucking.
We talked about help side earlier. And as Rudell Jones drove, Cody Zeller just absolutely cleaned out Williams, got him out of the way for one reason and one reason only. Zeller was low and determined. Williams was upright, still worried about his missed free throw.
Graff goes back inside, a bounce. Seibert lost it. Here's Oladipo up against Buford, and knocks it away. Stolen away by Ohio State. Some stingy defense. Kraft on the drive again. He's done that a number of times here in the first half.
And that's what has to happen till the end of this half. Buford and Kraft have to be the guys making the plays. Now, Seibert can shoot a jump shot. That's fine. And if the ball goes in the block to either Ravenel or Williams, he's got to get out of there. Kraft and Buford, that's it.
Whistle here away from the ball. 5:45 to go. 23-17 to score the foul on Buford. We've got Duke and Temple coming up on Wednesday, followed by Marquette and Georgetown. Georgetown coming off another outstanding win. Marquette, an awful shooting performance against Vanderbilt. At one point, they trailed in the first half 35-8.
And, you know, everybody said, well, Vanderbilt soft, Marquette's tough. That was kind of the lead to that. Well, it showed itself to be the other way. I still think Marquette's tough, but I think people kind of, you know, Vanderbilt got off to a tough start. Is Ely not playing? People kind of forget about it, but that's a good basketball team. That will be a good basketball team as we move through the SEC.
Marquette just had an awful shooting night. Yeah. Simple as that. Every team has those. You see Jones the third with over 1,200 career points. Done that rather quietly here at Indiana. Through the tough years, he's a senior now, getting a chance to finally enjoy being on a very competitive team.
I have a lot of respect for Cadell Jones. Indiana fans are all over him saying he over-dribbles. But the kid's come here. He's worked hard on the court. He's been an absolute representative of Indiana and Indiana basketball off the court. That's what I'm talking about. Kraft makes the play. He makes the play, and then others can clean it up.
And Williams is really making an impact in this game for Ohio State, with Sullinger on the bench with a couple of fouls, Thomas out with a couple of fouls. He has 4 points, but he's been a real presence in there.
He has on the offensive side. Now he has to be better here defensively.
Ball net there by Burdell Jones. He has 9 points a game coming in. And this one tightens up again, a 4-point lead for Ohio State. Ravenel into the paint. Offensive foul. Indiana ball with 4:46 left in the half.
A man has to know his limitations. Was it Dirty Harry moving? You just have to know that when you throw it in there, if you're Ravenel, if you have an angle, fine, but you don't need to go make a play.
That was not your best Clint Eastwood. You've done that much better.
I don't know that I was trying to imitate. I was just trying to quote, but you know, Indiana's going to let Ravenel get it. They're going to let Williams get it, play behind, make him score over, get it, kick it back out, repost, even get closer to the basket if you're Ravenel or Williams.
is the youngster Remy Abel, a freshman out of Louisville. He's being assigned right now to guard Kraft. Inside Zeller, knocked away. Williams with the foul. So Cody Zeller proving to be a handful. He's ninth in the nation in field goal percentage at 65%.
Well, Williams just plays too upright. You see Zeller's just lower with his hips, demanding the ball. Williams, well, he's skinny, so standing upright makes him weak. Now, he's a good offense. He's played well offensively here. But defensively, he's a shot blocker from either behind a post man or coming from the weak side. He's not a post defender just yet. In Indiana, good job taking advantage of it.
Two-point game. Kraft keeps on coming. Hit the deck. And a foul there. Could be a travel violation, so travel on Kraft. So Kraft gives it up.
Yeah, Remy Adele pretty good. Zeller comes over and doesn't reach, just keeps his feet moving. And Kraft, this time being low for Aaron Kraft, got himself off balance with the turnover and travel.
Indiana with an opportunity here to tie or take the lead. Another whistle with 4:02 to go.
No, that's a bad call. That's just a bad call. Williams had come over, was moving a little bit. Every touch in basketball doesn't have to be a foul. And that's just, you just play. And sometimes officials get so whistle happy, particularly for the home team.
Take another look here. Williams with the foul.
Williams is 23. He's just going to come over. He's just moving his feet. I guess he reached a little bit there, but this is the Big Ten.
Verdell Jones the third at the line, 74% foul shooter. And he can tie the game right here. And that is the first tie in the game.
Now you can tell Verdell Jones really confident right now.
Zell Smith trying to get away in a blocking foul that will go against Indiana and Derek Elston.
Well, a lot of ticky-tack fouls called here. I guess if you're going to call it on Ohio State, you got to call it on Indiana.
Gotcha. Well, Big Ten headlines, Ryan just mentioned the Hawkeye shocker at Wisconsin today. Trevor Mbakwe had knee surgery Friday to repair a right ACL, obviously gone for the year. And Big Ten and Pac-12 collaboration long-term scheduling commitments have been made across all sports. This is a good officiating crew, but both sides, both Indiana and Ohio State, the coaches have had some problems with some of the calls and the plethora of fouls.
Well, you like to see, you know, if it's a foul, call the foul. If it's something that affects a shot, then fine. But some of these calls to where there's just a little bit of a touch. This is the Big Ten. I mean, this is big boy basketball.
19 total fouls. It's pretty stiff. Terry Weimer is an outstanding official. They had a long
it's
talk.
It's a great crew.
Long talk with Thad Mata during the break. And it wasn't all roses. 3.5 to go here in the first half. Another foul here on Pritchard. Be his third. Indiana on a run here, 16-8 run since Sullinger picked up his second foul at the 10:38 mark.
Well, you have Sullinger, you have Thomas on the bench. You're talking about 35, 37 points. And when they're both out, and Buford's been on the bench as well, because you have four guys out there that aren't accustomed to being a focal point of an offense.
Charging. Great pass there and an easy dunk. The stuff by Sam Thompson coming off the bench.
Thompson's a terrific athlete out of Chicago.
He just committed the foul there with 3:06 left in the half. Thompson drew raves from Thad Mata in the preseason for his work at practice is saying that Thompson's probably the best athlete he's ever had.
Well, I'll tell you what, J.D. Witherspoon would give him an argument, because J.D. Witherspoon, number 15 for Ohio State, is a pretty good athlete too. But Thompson, they feel, as you said, he's going to be an outstanding player. You saw not only his athletic ability finishing with the dunk, but what a great catch, because Aaron Kraft fired that ball across his body in a short distance to Thompson.
Rudell Jones with another one coming. And the pair. ...29-27. Under three to go here at Assembly Hall first half. Kraft, a blocking foul. So that time the call goes against Indiana. Hall's a little bit slow to get up with some help.
Well, you're going to see Kraft just put his head down, go past Oladipo. Hall's is sliding to his right, and I'm guessing he's going to be inside the arc. No, he's outside the arc, but he was still sliding to his right. Last two possessions, I think Ohio State found something for the last 3 minutes, and that's a little bit of movement into a high ball screen with Aaron Kraft going to his right.
So Hulls with two personals goes to the bench. Kraft 67% at the line, leading Ohio State in assists and in steals. And that one rolls off the iron. So 3-point lead for the Buckeyes. Jones gives up the dribble. Green asks for a play now. Oladipo will start it. Zeller really commanding the ball, being pushed from behind by Ravenel further and further out of the lane. Shot clock at 9. Roth, Rudell Jones. Shot clock at 4. He'll lift it. That missed ugly. Oladipo strapped for it, and the shot clock will expire. Oh, wait a minute now. There was a timeout. And now the officials are going to get together. Mike Sanzier granted a timeout to Thad Mata.
I thought the shot clock went off before anybody established possession of the basketball.
But Sanzier said it was in the possession of the Buckeyes.
He did.
That's why he granted that timeout.
Yeah, he pointed right to the bench as if to give a timeout. You have 3 seconds, as you see. It's just going to be a matter of when possession is established.
The shot never touch the iron there.
You see in the background the zero and the light.
Now, given Thad's reaction, they're going to not allow that timeout. You can't see the clock there.
The other angle we had showed in the background, and here you'll be able to see it, but it's just going to be according to when. None of the officials, either the underneath official or the official in front of us, signaled shot clock violation.
Thad Mata did, though.
He did.
Thad Mata's the guy who wanted. There it is again. He wants that. He doesn't want to have to burn a timeout here.
Yeah, try to look in the background. You'll see above the basket on the other end. It's down to 2 right now.
Didn't look to me like anybody had possession.
No.
But I believe Thad Mata was also signaling for a shot clock violation. Did you see anybody on the Ohio State side ask for a timeout? Or did the player on the floor ask for a timeout?
Fans here are calling a timeout before he got the violation.
Okay.
So
he did get the timeout.
He got the timeout.
Terry Weimer came over and said they called it a timeout.
All righty. Kraft has it poked away. It'll be retained by Ohio State with 2:19 to go. So Ohio State is down to 2 timeouts. Kraft had trouble with it. Hits the deck. Asking for help. A tie-up. possession arrow will take it to the opposite end of the floor, but very, very good defense here by Indiana deep in the backcourt, even though the Buckeyes will retain.
Well, there's a lot of ways. You see right here, Aaron Kraft's the only guy working to get open. There's a lot of ways inexperience shows itself, and for Ohio State, it's nobody coming up to help Aaron Kraft. Now you see four guys are up.
Trying to get it in, and asks for once again. I mean, this has just been one of those situations where it's so tough to get it in. They've burned another one. Another timeout. Down to one. 30-27 Ohio State.
Even Thad Matta was laughing about the circumstance.
And what's happened here, without Sullinger, without Thomas, it's a very different offensive look by Ohio State.
It is, but last two possessions, Ohio State went to a ball screen, letting Aaron Kraft go to his right. He puts his head down and makes a play, and really, with this lineup, Kraft is the only guy that's capable of making a play on the road in an environment like this.
Kraft brings it across here as we approach 2 minutes to go in the opening half. Thompson handing to Kraft here, under two. Rebound scuffle, it'll go the other way. It'll be Indiana ball. Ohio State has just gone cold from three. They're 0 for 6. Indiana has never led in this game. Jones trying to bounce it. Watford is going to roll on out of play.
You know, I hate to keep beating a dead horse, but Indiana's post feeding is came back to haunt them late in the game against Kentucky, Michigan State game, and in this game as well. That pass needed to be taken below the foul line. Got an angle where the passer's shoulders are parallel to the postman's shoulders and thrown in there. That was just a lazy play, and that kills Indiana in big games.
Ravenel wants to go in strong with a right hand and gets two.
Well, that time Ravenel had a bit of an angle and brushed off Cody Zeller.
Zeller on the other end, trying to get around him. Boy, that's a tough move to back it in. That reverse, a thing of beauty for Cody Zeller.
Yeah, went to his left shoulder, kept his chin on the rim on the other side of the basket. Ravenel, though, when he had him under the basket, should have kept his feet moving and pinned him under the basket.
In the open floor, Verdell Jones. Off the turnover, it's a one-point game.
Got him again.
Oladipo this time. He slams it. Indiana with their first lead in the first half. A flurry of turnovers by Ohio State late. Look at Tom Crean playing defense. Thompson, heavy traffic. No. Oladipo comes away. Shot clocks are off. Indiana by one. They've been behind by as many as 10. And now Crean wants a timeout to set up a play. Hey, Indiana clamping down defensively.
Well, Victor Oladipo did this twice. He did this on the previous possession, which led to a Verdell Jones basket, came right back against Aaron Kraft, and took it from him at half court. Now, this possession, look for the ball to get in Watford's hands either on the block or setting a ball screen, pick, pop, looking for a three with Verdell Jones.
It's all changed since Jared Sullinger, the All-American, picked up his second foul. John Cougar Mellencamp. It's John Mellencamp now.
I call him the Coug.
The Coug? You can get away with that.
He's the Coug.
Very, very happy the way things are developing right now. 5.8 seconds before halftime. So it does indeed get it in. Verdell Jones taken away 1 second. And Ravenel did not get it off. It did not go anyway. And at the break, Indiana leads by one. What a surge by the Hoosiers down the stretch. They came from 10 points down a couple of different times in the first half to lead 33-32. Now we send it back to Ryan Burr, Doug Gottfried, and Andy Katz in the studio for the halftime report.